And we are back for part two of our vocab lesson. This is part two because it's not an ordinary Monday. This is actually a follow-up from our previous vocab lesson on formal letters and the 15 best words to use for formal letters. If you haven't seen that video, go back to last week, Monday, and check it out. For today, we're gonna do this lesson on the informal vocabulary. So again, I like to get to the point, but I do wanna mention this so it's clear. Informal vocabulary should be very simple. Okay, so you cannot use complicated words. You shouldn't even say, I'm looking forward to meeting you, because informal letters are for friends and family. Who do you ever say that to, that you're gonna look forward to meet this person if they're your friends or family? You don't, right? If you do, you're silly, so don't do that. Informal writing should be natural, and that's what the examiners expect or whoever you're writing to expect. Now, when we use words like good and bad, that's still a no-no because yes, I asked you to be simple, but not that simple. So there's a huge gap, a huge boundary between what is too simple and what is too complicated. So today my goal is to give you some words, 15 words that meet the criteria. And it's something you can use in all sorts of letters when it's informal because you will come across these situations. Let's talk about the very first one. How many times we talk about being happy, right? So we say, I'm really happy, but happy is a basic word. So you should use ecstatic. Ecstatic means extremely happy. All right, so I was ecstatic when I heard the news about your baby. Number two is upbeat. Now, upbeat is very similar to ecstatic or happy or joyous. The difference is upbeat could be used with people or events. Okay, so I was shocked because the party was so upbeat. I was not expecting that. So you can use it with party, or I was upbeat when I heard the news about my vacation. So that's another good word to use. Number three is swear by. Okay, so I'm gonna use a lot of phrasal verbs as well. And the reason is I'm not giving you guys complex vocab, okay? I'm very careful to do that. Like, I'm not gonna say, you know, if you wanna say, I want to have you in my basement for your vacation, you shouldn't say, I want to accommodate you in my basement. I'm very sure you will lose marks because we don't tell friends accommodate, right? We say, you can stay in my basement. But then you say stay, it's a very basic word. So I'm being very careful with the word usage. And sometimes the best approach is not to just go in the thesaurus and look at one word at a time. You can use two words, which are called phrasal verbs. So coming back to word number three, swear by, this is a phrasal verb. You can swear by something when you stand by it, you acknowledge it as something legit, and it's something used as a promise. So I went to the gym and I swear by their standards. It means their standards are amazing and I can promise you that they are the best. So I swear by that. Or if you're one of my students, hopefully you tell your friends that I swear by the lesson quality of HZad education. So that means you absolutely love it and you can promise, like you can be a referral for other people if you swear by something, someone, or some place. The next word is number four, absolutely. Absolutely is so simple. But why I wanted to write this here is because when you want to say completely, this is a good replacement. And you if you think, you know, in the informal letters, you don't say completely, you should, you know, you should have as many lees as possible, ly adverbs. They add to your range of vocab. If you don't know how important this is, a few days ago, well, actually more than a week ago, I did a review. You can check it out. CELPIP writing task to review. And I showed you how to use adverbs there. So, okay, you know, you should say, for example, you're talking about your experience with a vacation. So I went to Banff and I fell in love with it. Now you should say, I went to Banff and I completely fell in love with it. Completely will add that lee. So that's where you use it. Now when you do, say absolutely fell in love with that. Because again, we're trying to say adverbs, but not the very simple ones. Absolutely is a little more eccentric because we don't see that in papers much. Use absolutely instead of completely. Number five is stop by or come over. How many informal letters you get in your exams where they tell you to invite someone over? So you can say, why don't you come over? Why don't you stop by? Now, stop by is for mostly a short amount of time, but you can also use it for a long time. Why don't you stop by for 2 hours? just specify that. But if you say come over, that's probably going to be for dinner or sleepover. So that also can be used instead of just using the word invite. The next word is breakdown. So you want to express disappointment. You know, you want to say that I was not happy you didn't invite me last time to your party. Well, I broke down when I didn't receive your invitation. More fancy. Number 7, bring something up. So when you start a conversation, you can use bring something up. Now I can say today I brought up the topic of informal vocabulary. So it's something I started, something I created. So you bring something up if you want to start a conversation on a specific point. That's a good phrasal verb to use. Bring something up, three words together. Separately with space, of course. Call off, number 8. You wanna, you know, you're invited to a party, you wanna respectfully decline, but if you say the word respectfully decline, sounds too formal. So you wanna say, I'm sorry, but I have to call off my, I have to call off the party, or I have to call off coming over because of whatever. So it's something you are postponing or just putting off for a while, and you can say put off or call off. Well, actually, sorry. Call off is cancel. Call off would be to completely cancel and not come to the party anymore. Put off is more on postpone, so slight difference there. Okay, came down with the flu because of the weather. Okay, so you can use this as an excuse. You can go to the party of your friend. I'm sorry, Bob, I can't come over there right now because I came down with the flu this morning and I feel terrible. Okay, nice words to use. Do away with. Now, sometimes in these informal letters, you're suggesting someone something. That is very common, like you're suggesting your brother something, right? So you want to tell him you should do away with your video games. That means you should discard or get rid of your video games. That's a good word to, I mean, good combination of words. Do away with, discard, same meaning and fancy. All right, number 11 is breathtaking. You want to say something is good, don't say it's good. You know, okay, in the informal letters, saying that this is awesome instead of it's good will give you more marks because it's informal and it's fancy. But what will give you more marks than awesome is breathtaking. So it's usually the view was breathtaking, the event was breathtaking, your speech was breathtaking. It's more informal, it shows more expression, and it is, guess what? Fancy. The next word is give in. So you couldn't, you're talking about your vacation and you're saying that Bath was so absolutely beautiful. I gave in to the beauty of it and decided to move there. So it's like you gave up and you had some intention, you stopped what you were thinking and you decided to go with your gut. So it's like something you give up or you just surrender yourself. You give in to the feeling of whatever and start doing that thing. Okay, so my body was breaking down after all the workout. I just gave in. I quit work for that day and I slept. Okay, the next word is put something off. Actually, I was talking about this earlier. Postpone, put something off is the same thing. So your friend, again, you don't want to come to their party. And let me give you another example as well. You're saying that you're talking about a vacation. You're planning that. Let's say we put it off till next year because lockdowns are still happening. So you can put it off or delay it. Okay, number 14 is to turn up. Turn up means to show up suddenly. Again, this is more in the kind of situations where you're inviting someone or you're being invited. So you can say, look, I don't wanna turn up unexpectedly. Therefore, I wanted to ask you, is 2 p.m. on Sunday a good time? Okay, or you're giving someone your address, you can tell them, hey, my address is this, and just so you don't turn up when I'm not there, please come over at 5 p.m. I'm usually home at that time. So turn up means to show up, and it usually is suddenly, you know, you show up suddenly, so you can say turn up, I don't want to turn up without notifying you. It's like not telling you and then coming suddenly. And the last word is a very good word. I love it. It's not a word, it's a phrasal verb. For the sake of. Okay, so you want to say because. Instead of because, you can say for the sake of. Okay, so I can say I wanted to spend all this money for your gifts because I want to make your kids happy. So I wanted to spend all this money for your gifts for the sake of your kids' happiness. It's not formal, it is informal if used in that kind of situation for the sake of your happiness. It's something you're using with friends or family, keep them happy, to keep them pleased, or I wanna make sure I come to your party for the sake of your wife's mood because I know she'll be upset if I don't come. So it could be also used negatively, but also it's a good replacement for because. You know, mostly with because we say due to and we say since. That is still formal. For the sake of is a perfect replacement for an informal because, and it's a combination of words, gives you more marks, gives you more range of vocab. And that wraps up our part two of letter writing. I hope with this lesson and the one from last Monday, you guys are in a better position to use amazing vocab when you write and even when you speak. If you like this lesson, you find value, please subscribe, like, and share. Tell your friends about what we're doing here so we can spread our message across and get more people learning really good words, vocab, and great English lessons, as well as positivity content. This is Sean from HZad Education. I'll talk to you very soon. Take care.